You have a huge broad canvas here that you're writing on. I mean, it's international. It has to do with science. It has to do with CDC. It has to do with interesting characters. It has to do with how disease is transmission. It has to do with the fear that comes when something like this has happened. So what's the challenge here?
Well, the challenge is to avoid the cliches that typically fill this kind of, you know, scary modern horror film in a way. So, because as I said to Scott, I want it to be intimate. I want it to be personal. And so we sort of drew up a list of things that we didn't want to do in the film. For instance, cutting to a shot of Paris, even though none of our characters ever go there. I said, I don't want to do that. I don't want to see the president, yeah. You know, no actor right. playing the president. You know, we just sort of made a list of things that we'd seen before. And so then the film begins to be defined sort of by what you don't want it to be. And also, very late in the process, while we were watching the fallout from H1N1, which was happening while we were developing the script.
Just for a second, tell us what H1N1 is and was.
H1N1 was an influenza virus.
That scared the hell out of us.
That scared the hell out of everybody, and people in public health have been criticized for overreacting to it. Now, I don't agree with that, but yeah. I don't want to interrupt
the story.
This was
happening when you were involved in making this movie.
Right.
So one of the things we clocked while that was going on was this other voice that was emerging through the story, this sort of very critical, very suspicious, seeing conspiracies, and so that's when the Jude Law character sort of sprang
into being.
He plays
a guy who writes a blog and who's obsessed with telling the story as he sees it.
Yeah, and he puts pressure on our characters because he's constantly pounding them, you know, to reveal more information. He's got his own sort of ideological agenda that he's promoting. And that, there was a beautiful parallel.
Which is that all drug companies are bad.
Yeah, pretty much. Or at least out for themselves.
Right.
And there was a great parallel between the way his information spreads and the way the virus spreads. We thought that was a really nice dovetail. So.
Okay, here's what's interesting about the telling of the story. It is that you've got all these characters. And how do you have such a wide canvas to write on that you can make sure that it doesn't get lost in terms of such a big subject so that you keep it personalized?
That's called sweating in the editing room.
Is that what that is?
Yeah, it really is.
That's where you make it happen.
Yeah, we had, I would say, close to an hour of edited material that's not in the film. This was one of the, I'd say I had more versions of this film that I presented to Scott and the producers than any I've made, over 20. Mm-hmm. So a lot of trial and error, trying to find that balance between character and narrative, right. Trying to keep the movie moving as quickly as the virus, and having enough science to make you feel like it was real, but not so much that you just sort of fade away.
It doesn't sound like a textbook.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
So. But your preference is character over narrative, as I understand it.
Yeah. Always. I think people they connect with stories, but they connect with people first, you know? We look into people's eyes. This is how we judge them.
Whether they're alive and whether they're paying attention and whether they have something.
Yeah, so that's where we started before we even had a plot. Who are we following?
Right.
And then that's the discussion of, well, what happens? You know, what's the reality?
The other interesting, go ahead.
Just to follow up on characters, I mean, I can think of these characters as representatives of people I know, every single one of them.
All the doctors.
All the doctors, all the scientists,
victims.
And Jude Law's character.
Yeah,
we've seen them all. We've seen people selling false medications, false hopes, talking about vaccines causing autism and all kinds of things like
this. And hard choices by people in terms of trying to protect their own family, knowing the dangers of...
Absolutely. So it's very real. And the other thing I think that Scott did, which I very much appreciated, was the point that it was very democratic. So just because you're a star doesn't mean you can't get sick and die.
Will we experience a pandemic?
I think we'll have epidemics. We probably will have pandemics. The problem with the term pandemic is all it really means is that the virus is all over the world. It doesn't really tell you whether or not it causes significant disease. So the H1N1 pandemic was all over the world, but it didn't have any more ability to cause serious disease than regular seasonal flu, which every year takes 40,000 Americans.
Yeah.
and many more people globally.
Join us online at charlierose.com.